What's good out there, everyone? It's Roll Easy here, and I'm back with another GTA 5 online money glitch. This is the workaround to the last video I posted for SPMP Frozen Money, and this could be patched tomorrow, guys. So I wanted to get this out on Monday, restarted console, and it all works perfectly fine. Just follow the steps that I have in the video here. Now, shout out to the founders. They'll all be down in the description. And what you're going to need for this glitch is one friend, and you want that friend to be in an invite-only job. So you can see in the top right, that's the friend right there in an invite-only session going into the lobby screen of Titan of a job. So that's where your friend is. Now what I'm going to do is go online and I'm going to make sure my spawn location is set to last location somewhere outside. That's very important. You could get stuck in the clouds doing this glitch if you're not spawning outside for SPMP. Now, other than that, some people are having problems with game saves. I'm using a 3.2% save. It's on Complications, the third mission in Story, and it's working fine. This is mostly connection-based and timing-based, the issues people are having. And we'll get to that point in the video here in a few seconds. But yeah, so now that I've saved my last location somewhere outside, I'm just gonna go ahead and go back to Story. Now, once we're in Story, we're gonna do the same as before. I'm gonna input the cheat for getting cops for the wanted level. Now, I do believe this glitch works on Xbox as well. I can't confirm myself, but I have seen successful people hitting it on Xbox, so let me know down in the comments section. But I do know for sure it's working on PS4. Now, once I have one star on me, I actually had two, so I'm gonna have to put in the code to get the other star off. So we wanna get busted here, and we wanna press pause right when our hands go up. So here we go, hands go up, press pause. Now, here's the issue people are having. You wanna hover over choose character in the online tab. Now we're gonna be disconnecting and reconnecting to bring up menus behind menus. You see this right here? When I'm disconnected, I wanna hover over choose character when the menu behind the menu, and I'm gonna reconnect the internet. And while everything is grayed out, you wanna quickly spam on choose character. So I'm gonna try again here. I'm gonna disconnect, make sure I'm hovering over choose character. Now I'm gonna go ahead and reconnect and spam X twice, okay? Right when it lets me, boom. See that? And that's the alert that you need to get up, all right? The Rockstar Game Services are unavailable. Now, once you're on this alert, this is where your friend comes in. You wanna go ahead and don't touch that alert at all. Just join back into the party, and you wanna join your friend that's still sitting in that invite-only lobby job, okay? The Titan of a job. So I'm gonna join my friend here, and I'm gonna wait about 15, I'd say 10 to 15 seconds on this alert so that the join alert can pop up in the background, okay? Now, once that has popped up in the background and I'm sure I've waited 10 to 15 seconds, I'm gonna accept this first alert and I'm gonna let that one go. I didn't accept that second alert. I only accepted the first one. You should hit a black screen just like this. Once you're on this black screen, you wanna go back to the party and join your friend once more, accept the first alert and accept the second alert for the private. Now, at this point, this is where the workaround comes into play. So you want your friend that's in that job, in that same job that he's been in the whole time, to send you an invite, just like this, since we're in an invite-only job there. You want to accept that invite. Once you've accepted it, sit on this alert. You do not want to touch this alert at all. This alert's going to go away, all right? This is the join alert that we need right when we spawn down in session. Okay, so the new patch that they've done, and there's a lot of hang time here, so I'm gonna be fast forwarding as much as I can. But the new patch that was done was that once you spawn in and your character splits, you get an error joining session and you end up getting kicked back to Story. So this invite that we just got is gonna be the alert that pops up the second we hit the ground and we're about to split. You wanna accept that, okay? And I say spam X or A quickly, quickly, so that you can get that right before the split and you'll load into your friend's job that he's been sitting in this whole time. Okay, I hope you understand all of that because we spent way too much time up here in the clouds. But this is how this glitch goes, okay? So we're loading in now, and right before the split, we should get that alert, and you want to accept it, okay, quickly. So we're spawning down, accepted it, and you even see the split there. Surprisingly, I split and I didn't get the error. But if you've done it correctly, you should be loading straight into your friend's job just like this, okay? So that's the hardest part, but there is still a little bit of a workaround you have to do. You want your friend to leave this job right now, as you see in the top right, and you want your friend to start up another job in that same session, okay? This is the last thing your friend needs to do. All right, start up another job in the same session, And once your friend's done that, you want to confirm settings and you want to get ready to accept the old invite that your friend sent you. All right, you see this old invite? That was the first one up in the clouds that I accepted. So I'm going to double tap and get ready to accept this alert. All right, so now I'm going to start this job just like this. I'm going to launch it. I'm going to accept the old invite to my friend's job. And once I've gotten that invite up and the alert, I'm going to tell my friend to back out of their job and I'm going to accept the alert. And it should look something like this. Unable to connect to session, the session may no longer exist, or player is no longer in the job. You'll get some alert like that, okay? And if you've done it correctly, you'll go up in the clouds, you'll be loading, and then you will come back down without any sort of split. This is how we're avoiding the split that kicks you back to story, all right? It's something like this, all right? So there's a few ways around the internet that people are doing this, but this way was pretty simple for me, okay? So as you can see right here, I spawned in perfectly fine, no split. And the way you can check to see if you're SPMP is the double menu. Open up the interaction menu and your double menu, you know you're glitched out. So from this point, you wanna eat a peyote. Now, peyotes can be eaten in sessions like, you know, just a regular online session or in a job. Now, I was doing it in a regular session here. I showed you the location there. I'll leave a link down in the description for more peyote locations, but I like using this one from time to time. As you can see, it's to the east of this house. You're gonna see a couple piles of rocks here. Go to this one, and the peyote is right over here. So simply hit right D-pad while you're over the peyote, press the pause menu, go to the online tab and get ready to find new session. I say after a few seconds, there's no crazy timing to that part. So once you've done that, you're gonna be loading up into a brand new session. And in this session is where you'll actually have your frozen money, okay? And we'll be able to buy anything we want. So as we're spawning down here, you will spawn in all crazy looking like this. Very, very simple. We're in the session. We're all good to go. Just press pause, go to online and go to jobs and start up a Titan of a job. And you want to just go into the lobby and you'll see kind of everything fixing, all the textures in the background. And once you load into the job, simply back out and we should be spawning in completely normal. No split, no nothing. Now, open up your interaction menu and you'll see that there's no double menu anymore. That's okay. Go to your ammo and you want to test to make sure you have frozen money. You're going to go ahead and buy some ammo and you see that I have frozen money. That's how you know. That's the confirmation right there. So at this point, you probably want to go into passive mode. I didn't, but I'd recommend you go into passive mode and you don't have access to your phone. So I'm just going to buy stuff through the Criminal Enterprise pause menu area that you saw there. And I'm gonna buy Deluxos. Now I had plenty of money for Deluxos, but make sure you have the amount at least to buy one and you'll be able to buy as many as you want. Now I'm gonna fill up one garage here. Okay, I'm just gonna fill up one garage with Deluxos really quickly. And I'm gonna show you guys a little thing I should have added in my last video to where you don't have to, you know, swap the cards, or you do have to swap the cards. Here's the situation. If those cards are delivered while you're still frozen money glitched or in a hallucination, then they need to be swapped. But if they're delivered after the fact, then they don't need to be swapped. But if you want to just be, you know, sure of yourself, just go ahead and swap them regardless. Now, I'm going to fly over to the garage where I ordered all my Deluxos, and I'm going to get unglitched. I'm going to go ahead and kill the frozen money. The way to do that is to kill yourself. Take the easy way out, and once you've done that, you should spawn back in without frozen money. Okay, this is how I'm unglitching myself so that I can get the cars to save, all right? And you would have done this after buying, you know, a bunch and filling up all your garages or even doing the apartment glitch. So at this point, I'm gonna go ahead and show you. I have double menu again, that's good. I'm gonna buy some ammo and I indeed have unglitched the frozen money and I'm just regular now, okay? Regular. So this is where I'm gonna go into the garage and I'm gonna swap these cars to make sure that they stick. I don't know exactly when they were all delivered, but I'm not taking any chances. You shouldn't, especially if you're filling up all your garages, because that does take a long time. So once I'm in my garage where I just bought these 10 fresh new Deluxos, I'm gonna go ahead and just swap them just like this. I'm gonna take the first car and just put it into every slot. All right, every slot, continue on until you get back to the first slot and you should be good to go. You wanna do this for every garage that you bought Deluxos for. If you bought Oppressors, you wanna do the same thing. Now, once you've switched all your cars to make sure that they save, you wanna force a game save by choosing style and selecting your outfit or buying ammo, something of the sort. And yeah, you should be good. Now, the rest of the video is just me proving that everything does stick. I'm gonna go ahead and head to Creator, or I clicked Creator at this point and it's still gonna kick me to story mode. That's okay. It's just unglitching me. I'm going to pause and go back online, and I'm going to show you that inside that garage, everything has indeed stuck. Okay? I'd say just swap them if you're not sure when the vehicles were delivered. Once you unglitch yourself, once you kill yourself and you have frozen money no more, you want to just swap everything around just to be sure. And you only have to do it once. Once you've swapped everything around, you should be good to go. And as you can see right here, everything is still there after going to story and back, which tells me that it's good. All right, no double menu, I'm unglitched, and all the cars are there. So now you can do what you want. All right, sell them or just look at them and that's it. All right. So that's going to be it, guys, for me. That is the SPMP, frozen money. Okay. Workaround. That's going to be all for me. My name is Roll Easy. I hope you enjoyed the video. Subscribe, like it, do what you got to do. I'll be back for more. Until next time, take it easy, guys.